Welcome to CBN News This Morning. I'm Charlene Israel. The country's eyes are on Virginia, New Jersey, and Maine on the eve of key elections there. The results could have national implications, and that's why President Obama was out again this weekend to support his party. Our Ephraim Graham is in the newsroom following this story. Ephraim?
1 year after American voters elected Barack Obama president, much of the country is quiet this election week, but there's no time to rest in Virginia and New Jersey, where tense governor's races continue to heat up less than 24 hours before the polls open. The results will give hints about this country's state of mind before pivotal 2010 midterm contests.
It wasn't a consequence of Obama policies or Corzine policies that we went into this hole.
President Obama was on the campaign trail Sunday, stomping for New Jersey Governor John Corzine. Polls show him in a tight race with GOP candidate Chris Christie, despite the state's heavy Democratic leaning.
Today, I'm standing with President Obama. That tells you all you need to know about what we stand for and what they stand for.
In Virginia, polls are on the side of Republican Bob McDonnell. He leads Democrat Cree Deeds, even though the state went heavily for Democrats in 2008.
The only poll that counts is the one that's going to be taken on Tuesday. Right.
Republicans say both races are a referendum on President Obama.
After a year now, almost, of the Obama administration setting out broad policies, the country, writ large, but certainly here in Virginia, is saying, not so much.
In Maine, voters head to the polls to decide the issue of same-sex marriage. If voters approve it, it'll be the first state where voters make same-sex marriage legal. The White House is downplaying any political fallout from the results of any of these races. Reporting in the newsroom, Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
The governor's races in Virginia and New Jersey may be getting the most attention in this off-year election, but another race is also making news. The battle for New York's 23rd congressional district has exposed a rift in the Republican Party, and it could be a sign that the GOP is returning to its conservative roots. John Waggie has the story.
The battle to replace Republican Congressman John McHugh, who became President Obama's Army Secretary, has turned into a high-stakes venture. GOP County Chairman had chosen New York Legislature Dede Scozafava for their candidate to replace McHugh. She's pro-choice, pro-gay marriage, and conservatives say she has a bad record on taxes and spending. She was challenged by Doug Hoffman, a political newcomer who was running as the Conservative Party candidate. This weekend, Scozafava dropped a bombshell when she withdrew from the race, trailing in the polls behind Hoffman and the Democrats' candidate, Bill Owens.
I think it is a warning to the Republican Party that you can't nominate a candidate in a district that alienates almost the entire conservative base. With the exception of gun control, Dede Scozafava, the official Republican candidate, is liberal on everything. In fact, she's more liberal than half of the Democrats in the New York State Legislature.
Scozafava had won endorsements from Newt Gingrich and the NRA. Gingrich now backs Hoffman and joins Sarah Palin, Minnesota governor and would-be presidential candidate Tim Pawlenty, and more than a dozen other prominent conservatives who came out early for Hoffman. Some Democrats scoff at the conservatives' influence on the race.
I think what you're going to see in the coming months, if not years, is Sarah Palin, you know, by the way, she's kind of playing the role as Pied Piper in the Republican Party, which is something I'm quite comfortable with. So Sarah Palin, the other Republican candidates who are likely to run, the Limbaughs and Becks of the world, are basically hanging a moderates need not apply sign outside the Republican National Committee headquarters.
But Fun thinks it's good for Republicans that they were slow to read the mood of restlessness and anger from the Tea Parties, because the protests sprung from the conservative grassroots rather than from party backing.
I think the Republican Party is playing catch up, but I think they finally figured out a little bit of what the public mood is, which is very suspicious and skeptical of a federal budget that borrows 46 cents out of every dollar we're spending this year.
John Waggie, CBN News.
Turning now to the election in Afghanistan, the top challenger to President Hamid Karzai has dropped out of the runoff vote, handing a victory to Karzai. The August 20th race was marred by fraud, but challenger Abdullah Abdullah says the runoff would have been stacked against him, too. UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is now in Afghanistan after a UN investigation found the fraud in favor of Karzai. It's unclear if he will push for the runoff vote to go forward as planned this coming weekend. And October was the deadliest month of the 8-year Afghan war. Three of the 55 Americans killed were agents with the Drug Enforcement Agency. CBN News spoke with the director of the DEA, who was there at Dover Air Force Base when the men's bodies were returned.
Wednesday night, we had an opportunity to sit down with the families of our three fallen heroes. We also had an opportunity that night not only to meet with the families, but I got to welcome back the agents that served with the three agents that were killed. They looked me in the eye and they all told me they needed three things. They needed to be back here to see the families of the fallen agents. They needed to be back here to go see their families. And then they needed to return to Afghanistan to finish the mission. Afghanistan is a major source of heroin. As long as there are drug lords there funneling funds to terrorist organizations and producing the type of drugs and the quantity of drugs that they are producing, we'll be there. And we will need to be there until we have an Afghan national police and narcotics entity capable of taking that over.
And for more of this interview and our other reports on Afghanistan, go to CBNNews.com and look for the Boots on the Ground blog there. And much like a corporation, Al-Qaeda maintains regional franchises around the world. One of the terror group's most active branches is based in North Africa. As Eric Stackelbeck reports, Europe and America are in its crosshairs.
Top Al-Qaeda leaders say that if they get their hands on Pakistan's nuclear weapons, they'll use them. So when a physicist at this Swiss nuclear lab was arrested this month and charged with having ties to Al-Qaeda, counterterrorism officials took notice. They believe he was in contact with a group known as AQIM, Al-Qaeda in the Islamic Maghreb. It's an area of North Africa that extends from Morocco to Libya on down to Mali. AQIM has carried out deadly bombings throughout the region. A number of its members have experience fighting U.S. troops in other Al-Qaeda hotspots.
Some go to Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq.
Lieutenant Colonel Rudy Atala worked until recently as the Pentagon's Director of Counterterrorism for Africa. He says AQIM's pipeline reaches into neighboring Europe.
They have the connections to where they can, you know, move people, passports, and that kind of stuff in the European areas and back into the Middle East.
And the group is on the record threatening Europe and the United States. AQIM's leader told the New York Times in 2008 his followers share the goals of Al-Qaeda's hierarchy in Pakistan, saying, quote, "Everyone must know that we will not hesitate in targeting the United States whenever we can and wherever it is on this planet." One weapon used against the West is kidnapping, including Christian missionaries. They're often held for ransom in the remote Sahara Desert region of Mali, where the group has several terror training camps.
More last year, we've had Austrians, Swiss, UK citizens kidnapped. That's interesting to me because what you see is Al-Qaeda trying to make money any which way it can.
An Arab government official tells CBN News that AQIM has become heavily involved in the African drug trade as a way to fund its operations. The official added that the terror group Hezbollah has also established a foothold in the region. It, too, works closely with drug cartels. Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Washington.
Thanks, Eric. Radical Islam is on the rise in Great Britain, but so are demonstrations by those who say enough is enough. Dale Hurd has this report from Leeds.
Protesters converged on the town of Leeds in northern England in a face-off over Islamic extremism. Leeds has a large Muslim community. A new group called the English Defense League wants the government to do more against the growing influence of radical Islam. Protesters were clearly angry with their government and took it out on police.
Whether you like the English Defense League or not, this is real grassroots anger, and this is the failure of multiculturalism in Britain.
The night before the protest, leaders of the English Defense League took us to their secret meeting place north of London to explain their views. My first question was, why are they wearing masks?
The people we're protesting against and the people we feel we're going to bring heat on in this country are Islamic extremists who are trained in terrorism. They are linked to suicide killings and mass murder. And quite frankly, they were killing in the name of Allah. And we shouldn't have to put our faces up against these people. Our government are here to protect us, to protect our communities, and they're not.
The English Defense League says they're not fascist, racist, anti-Semitic, or anti-Muslim. They say they're only against Islamic radicals who want to bring Sharia law to Britain.
Is everyone scared or worried being called a fascist or a racist or Islamophobic, etc.? And it's this thing that they keep beating everyone back down with, where people feel oppressed and scared to even talk about Islam.
The EDL vows to keep marching against radical Islam. It wants to create a grassroots national political movement in Britain. Dale Hurd, CBN News, in Leeds, in Northern England.
Financial lender CIT Group has filed for bankruptcy. The company is one of the nation's leading funders of small and medium-sized businesses. CIT made its filing after a debt exchange offer to bondholders failed. The lender's reorganization plan will reduce its total debt by $10 billion while allowing the company to continue to do business. Taxpayers will lose the $2.3 billion the government gave to the company as part of the financial bailout last fall. The bankruptcy is one of the biggest filers in U.S. corporate history. The company expects to emerge from bankruptcy by the end of the year. And the health care reform legislation could include a backdoor tax hike. Congress is considering a limit on employee health care flexible spending accounts. Those flex accounts are currently tax-free. Workers put money into them to pay for dental work, co-payments, and some medications. Currently, there is no cap on annual employee contributions, but proposed legislation would cap contributions at $2,500. That would limit the employee income tax exemption and result in a tax increase. Lawmakers say this would raise more than $13 billion over the next 10 years. Remember all of that federal stimulus money? Well, you won't believe some of the unusual things that are being done with some of that money. In fact, some people are getting an $8,000 tax credit, get this, for buying a souped-up golf cart. Wendy Griffith has more.
Want to ride in style on the golf course? Uncle Sam is willing to help you out. Under the president's stimulus plan, if you buy an electric vehicle, you can get a check back for up to $7,500. And golf cart manufacturers found a way to cash in by selling their carts as street-legal, low-speed vehicles. But don't call them golf carts.
I only came in because I was impressed with the fact of the rebate.
I could foresee using this for all of my driving within our community.
How about this Hummer model? The price tag is 18 grand, but with a government rebate, you'll get $6,000 back, enough to add a few bells and whistles. And business is good for one Florida golf cart man.
Business is excellent. These are all orders.
This model costs less than $9,000, but gets a federal rebate of $6,500. That's more than the $4,500 car buyers got from the Cash for Clunkers program. And you had to give up your car to get that. And it's nearly as much as the first-time homebuyer tax credit of $8,000. And that's to buy a whole house. But if you fancy a souped-up golf cart, street-legal low-speed electric vehicle, you might want to hurry. This tax credit runs out at the end of the year. Wendy Griffith, CBN News.
Coming up, suspect arrested. Why people say he targeted an Israeli Christian boy with a terrorist bomb.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time. And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to you.
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love,
get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only $24.99.
Here I am for worship. Here I
but wait. Order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just $9.99. Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Dr. James Dobson, known to millions as the host of the Focus on the Family radio program, is leaving the daily radio broadcast. Focus on the Family spokesman Gary Sheenberger says Dobson will go off the air at the end of February. He called it a mutual decision of Dobson and the board of directors and said more details are forthcoming. Dobson has taken a reduced role at the ministry that he founded as part of a succession plan. He resigned as president in 2003 and as board chairman last February. Israeli police have made an arrest in the Ami Ortiz attempted murder case. The suspect also allegedly killed two Palestinians, tried to kill a left-wing university professor, and warned he would attack police at a gay pride parade. Ortiz is the Israeli Christian boy who was nearly killed in a bombing attack that made news around the world. Here's Chris Mitchell.
Israeli police say the suspect plotted to bomb the Ortiz family. According to court documents, police found explosives and weapons in his home. The arrest marked the end of a long wait for the Ortizes. The bombing took place here in Ariel 1.5 years ago in March of 2008. The bomb destroyed the Ortiz family apartment, shattered car windows 3 stories below, and left 15-year-old Ami Ortiz near death. His parents say after a year of intensive medical treatment and prayer from believers around the world, Ami made a miraculous recovery. Still, the announcement deeply affected them.
It was very chilling. In other words, I felt like my heart go cold, because even though we know that there are people, actual flesh and blood people that did it, just the fact that we found out what settlement they were from, that they were neighbors.
I felt pain for these people. I started praying for them this morning. I mean, here you go, trying to kill people and assassinate people, and you ruin your whole life.
We heard about their story when they contacted us, and we were amazed by the fact that it could be done by a fellow Jew, and we decided to take care of this case on ideological basis.
Yossi Graver represents the Ortiz family.
For me, it was the most natural thing is to defend the Ortiz family as a part of a group of a minority in Israel against other people that think differently than them. It's a legitimate reason to try to assassinate and to kill them.
Despite the year and a half ordeal and their son nearly killed, the Ortizes still want the bomber to know the gospel.
That even though there's people out there that despise the Lord, I would like to, in one way or another, to convey to them that Yeshua is the Messiah, and he hasn't forgotten the promises he made to their forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
CBN News has learned the suspect is a U.S.-Israeli citizen. Police are investigating groups who may have a connection to the bomber and the possibility they helped finance it from America, which would be a violation of U.S. law.
Israel and America have an agreement concerning security and terrorism. And these people operating from and collecting donations from American citizens to bring here to work against Messianic Jews.
In Israel, the Ortizes hope the case will improve religious freedom for Messianic Jews, those who believe Jesus is the Jewish Messiah.
That we as believers can exercise our freedom of religion and to openly exercise our faith without fear of being firebombed, bombed, harassed, you know, jobs being lost, kids thrown out of school, whatever. And it'll be I just pray that this will lead to greater religious freedom for the body of Messiah in Israel.
Despite the attempted murder, Ortiz says believers need to stand by Israel.
They should continue praying for Israel, supporting Israel. These radicals are less than 1% of the population. They don't represent the Israeli public. So we should continue loving Israel. And one thing about these things, we're not only called to love our friends, we're also called to love our enemies too.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Ariel.
Up next, could there be a truce in the White House's war with Fox News?
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where He performed His miracles, to see where He taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
There may be a sign of a truce after the very public White House battle with the Fox News network. It's a meeting between the White House press secretary and a top Fox executive. The White House has said it would treat Fox as an opponent and called the network biased and nothing more than a research arm of the Republican Party. Some analysts believe the administration went too far. CBN News White House correspondent David Brody has more.
The war against Fox News started with these words by White House Communication Director Anita Dunn.
The reality of it is that Fox News often operates almost as either the research arm or the communications arm of the Republican Party.
Ever since, Fox News has jabbed the White House repeatedly, like plotting war strategy on a New York City map with Fox News headquarters.
I'm showing where the enemy is. So we got the missiles pointed right at Fox, and let's make sure that everybody understands this is the enemy, America. Everything that's going wrong in the country happening right here.
Something very disturbing about the Obama administration fighting harder against Fox News than the Taliban.
Fox News has been pounding this night after night after night. It enables Fox to position itself as the only news organization that's holding the administration's feet to the fire.
It's also enabled Fox's ratings to shoot up. Since this war began, ratings on the news channel are up around 10%. And on the internet, a new Facebook site asks people to be a Foxer and support Fox News. The White House decided not to make anyone available for an interview for this story. In recent days, White House officials have signaled a desire to get away from the back and forth with Fox and put the focus back on fixing the economy. One well-known snub came on a recent Sunday when the president didn't appear on Fox with Chris Wallace, but made the other network shows. And now, even other news outlets are uneasy about the battle. They even came to Fox's defense when it wasn't on a list allowed to interview White House Pazar Kenneth Feinberg. The White House called it a misunderstanding, and Fox did end up getting the interview. A Fox News senior vice president tells us, quote, "Hundreds of journalists come to work each day at Fox News, all deeply committed to their craft. It's disappointing that the White House would be so dismissive of their fine work and continue their vengeful war against a news organization." And what about the other side? The White House has been silent about the liberal bias on MSNBC with hosts like Rachel Maddow, Keith Olbermann, and Chris Matthews.
I do have to wonder why the Obama White House is so offended by the opinionmeisters at Fox News, but of course doesn't criticize the people who do opinion for a living in MSNBC, who happen to be on the liberal side of the spectrum.
The main White House strategy at this point is keeping the major networks and papers like the New York Times and Washington Post from paying attention to Fox. It was Fox that reported heavily on the Tea Party movement and controversial administration figures like Van Jones and Kevin Jennings. So how will all of this eventually play out?
Ultimately, President Obama will appear on Fox News again, but each side will have gotten something out of this. The White House has thrown this brushback pitch to tell the rest of the media, be very wary of what you see reported or trumpeted on Fox News. And Fox's ratings keep going up because it gets to revel in this perception that it is the most skeptical news organization when it comes to this administration.
David Brody, CBN News, Washington.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use. Kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Finally this morning, in these tough economic times, people resort to all kinds of creative ways to make a little extra money. Take Pablo Izquierdo, for example, a.k.a. Pablo the Clown. His hours were cut back and his wife lost her job completely. So he dusted off this costume he found lying around the house and started performing on the streets of Miami, juggling and rollerblading for donations.
My wife is out of job, and my salary is not as before. So this is something that I love to do, because I used to use this costume for my son's birthday and for my daughter's birthday. So now I'm doing it for all the people, because I can make them happy.
And as you might imagine, Pablo's performing was somewhat of a traffic hazard, especially during rush hour. Police asked him to move his show to a safer location, but hey, you can't blame a guy for trying, right? Well, that is going to do it for this edition of CBN News this morning. Remember, you can always stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day, everybody.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance in just
just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just two easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.